Do you find that you can't function in the mornings unless you've had a cup of coffee? Or are you a devoted drinker of your favorite seasonal latte? There's a good chance you're not alone. Coffee is being consumed in greater quantities than ever before, with an estimated 68% of adults drinking at least one cup per day in 2021. Because coffee is so popular, it's no surprise that there's a lot of discussion about its health advantages or risks, including how it impacts everything from depression to cancer. One of the most frequently debated topics is whether coffee is helpful or bad for diabetics. Here are the facts. Before we hop in, we'd love you to give us a like. And make sure to subscribe to STATERA to keep up with all our latest content. Plus, later in this video, we'll reveal a free gift you can grab today right now. Though it's time to discover, how does coffee affect diabetics? When you have diabetes, your body either doesn't produce enough insulin or doesn't use it well. Insulin is a hormone produced by your pancreas that helps you transfer sugar from your food into your cells, where it is transformed into energy. Your cells won't be able to absorb sugar if you can't generate insulin or your body can't use it, so it builds up in your blood instead. Excessive thirst and urination, as well as weariness and dizziness, are common diabetic symptoms. Diabetic consequences might include kidney illness, eye loss, nerve damage, and heart problems. When you think about coffee and diabetes, you might automatically assume it's harmful to you due to the amount of sugar it contains. However, you might be shocked to learn that coffee isn't inherently bad for your health. Coffee contains two main components that can affect its health. The first component, antioxidants. According to research, coffee contains a variety of antioxidants, which can benefit your health by reducing inflammation and neutralizing harmful atoms known as free radicals, which can promote aging and illness. The second component, caffeine. Caffeine is probably the most well-known component in coffee. Caffeine is a natural stimulant, and may be keeping you awake at work, but it has been shown to raise blood pressure and impair insulin sensitivity, or how well your body responds to insulin, in coffee drinkers with diabetes. Unfortunately, research into whether coffee is healthy or dangerous for diabetes has yielded contradictory results, partially due to a lack of thoroughness in the studies. According to several research, drinking coffee on a regular basis can raise blood sugar levels and make you more insulin resistant. Other research, on the other hand, suggests that long-term, daily coffee consumption may have the opposite impact. According to one study, adults who drank more than 6 cups of coffee per day had a decreased risk of diabetes than those who consumed 4 to 6 cups per day. Even those who drank 1 to 4 cups per day had a decreased risk of diabetes than those who did not. The specific cause of this event is uncertain, but one theory is that the caffeine in coffee improves insulin sensitivity, which means that cells are better able to absorb sugar and remove it from the blood, resulting in lower blood sugar levels. Despite these findings, it's crucial to note that they don't prove that coffee actually decreases blood sugar. Rather, they show that regular coffee drinkers in the study had a lower long-term risk of diabetes. The trials also didn't say how much sugar was in the coffee or whether any was used at all. In addition, a variety of factors, including as your daily diet and exercise habits, other medical illnesses, and a family history of diabetes, might influence your blood sugar levels and risk of developing diabetes. Overall, the judgment is still out, and increasing your coffee consumption as a diabetes preventative or cure is not advised. Although the evidence for coffee's advantages is varied, drinking coffee should be safe as long as you keep an eye on your blood sugar and stick to coffee with less sugar. You can treat coffee like any other food, watching how much sugar you put in it and making sure you don't consume too much caffeine. In general, the FDA recommends that a healthy adult consume no more than 400 milligrams of caffeine per day, approximately 4 to 5 cups of coffee. However, if you have diabetes, a lower limit may be good. Caffeine intake of more than 200 milligrams may have a detrimental impact on blood sugar in some diabetics. The World Health Organization recommends that adults without diabetes consume less than 10% of their total calories from sugar. For a 2,000-calorie diet, this translates to 50 grams of total sugar per day from all sources. It's especially crucial to remember this when ordering coffee. A single Starbucks mocha can contain up to 25 grams of sugar. If you have diabetes, you should consult with your doctor to determine the optimal limit for you. Instead of a fixed amount of sugar, determining this restriction as a percentage of your total daily calories may make it easier to regulate your intake based on how much you eat or how much you weigh. Finally, if you have any specific nutritional questions or concerns, don't be shy to comment below the video. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to STATERA, your hub for diabetes fighting knowledge. And before we forget, you've got a free gift waiting just for you. Discover more diabetes fighting foods in this book, The Complete Diabetes Cookbook. This book contains 400 recipes specially designed for diabetics. To grab the gift, simply click the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. We hope you have a happy and healthy day.